seems like nothing is working for our good, but you have an unction in your spirit that this is not the end for you. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, this is not the end. Come on now, talk to your neighbor and say, neighbor, this is not the end. Right then and there is when you need to come up from where you are and push yourself and move. Push your neighbor and say, it's time to push. Because where you are is killing you even more. The woman knew that if she stayed there, then she would die there. Where you are, things are not going to get better. But you need to come up from where you are, because where you are is something about the situation. If you dwell there long enough, the situation would get in your mind and get in your spirit and contaminate your mind and contaminate your spirit. And then your spirit will be down, and then you're walking around with a frown and saying, there's nothing that I can live for. But I dare you to hurt your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's time we gotta push. And I'm going to tell you that this year I'm not going through my struggle like I did on last year. Because now I'm being pushed to do greater. Hurt your neighbor and say, we're being pushed to do greater. Hallelujah. You might have went through a period in time in 2011 where it seemed like something or something nearly drained the life out of you. Am I talking to anybody? It seemed like it nearly drained the life out of you. But I come to tell you that when the clock struck 12 o'clock midnight, and I walked over into my new situation, and I walked over into my new year, and I walked over into a new atmosphere in the spirit, I believe that God is going to erase everything that the enemy did in 2011. I believe that God is going to erase all the pain that I went through in 2011. Is there anybody that believes that when you crossed over, something pushed you, and you believe that God is going to erase everything that the enemy did back in 2011? Because now I've been pushed into 2012. Say that, neighbor, look out. It's only January, but some things are about to happen. Tell your neighbor, look out, because doors are about to open. Tell your neighbor, watch out, because the news is about to be good. Not just for me, but on your behalf. Am I talking to anybody that's ready for good news? You done suffered long enough. You done went through long enough. But it's about time for some good news to happen. Well, how about your neighbor and tell them, keep watching out, because I've been pushed into some good news. Hallelujah. Has anybody been pushed? Tell your neighbor, don't touch me. Tell them, don't push me, because I'm on the edge. I'm on the edge of a breakthrough. I'm on the edge of something good coming in my life. I'm on the edge of something miraculous happening for my family members. I'm on the edge of something fresh and something new, because now I've been pushed into a new generation that will live and worship God with no restrictions. It's time out for coming in the church as usual, but I'm looking for a no restriction church that's not program bound, because you've been pushed into a new situation. There's something that's keeping me, and there's something that's keeping me. I don't mean to preach this early, but I feel the spirit of God, because there's something that's keeping me. It's pushing me to another level. There's something that's keeping me. It's pushing me to do greater than I've ever been before. Look out, because greatness is pushing me. Hope is pushing me. Success is pushing me. Anybody been pushed? Is anything pushing you? But I know about me, that greater is pushing me. Healing is pushing me. Faith is pushing me. Long life is pushing me. I don't know about you, but there is something on the inside that won't stop pushing. There's something on the inside that won't your neighbor and say, flow with the brooks. Look at your neighbor and say, flow with the brooks. Yeah. I can't stop now. I can't give up now. Because the brooks won't let me stop. The brooks won't let me give up. The brooks won't let me pause. The brooks won't let me stand still. The brooks won't let me quit. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Now your neighbor, say neighbor, say neighbor. Now faith is in you. But you got to allow the push to push you to your fullest potential. Look at your neighbor and say neighbor. You got to allow God to push you and stretch you out to your greatest potential. Where you are is good, but there's greater for you. And I tell you one thing, I'm going to flow with the brooks. Because God is pushing me in some great stuff. Because he pulled me out of some dark places. And he let me live. That's why I'm going to flow with the brooks. He's pushing me forward away from those no good friends. He's pushing me away from the backbiters. He's pushing me away from the people that will hinder me. Look at somebody and tell them, don't mind me. You may see me, or you may not, but just know that I'm being proved. Tell your neighbors, is there anybody that's seeing proof? Hallelujah. Anybody feel a push this morning? Hallelujah. He's pushing you right now. And if you ask me why I got so much back pain, I'll tell you that I'm being pushed when I don't even feel like it. I'm being pushed when I don't feel like coming to church. But I find myself walking through the door. I'm being pushed to walk away from sin. When my flesh wants to give in, the push says, keep it moving. No one inside me. It's not a push, because you're on assignment. Look at your neighbor and say, don't stop. You gotta keep going. This is not the end. Look at somebody and say, this is not the end. Hold faith and say that the Lord is good, and he's pushing you right now. I feel a push in my spirit. I feel a push in my soul. I thank God that he's pushing me. You may ask me, well, what's behind the push? And I'll tell you that faith is behind the push. When my faith connects with my spirit, it activates a momentum that pushes me to destiny. Anybody got the momentum that's pushing you to destiny? Therefore, I can't have no room for a pity party. There's no room for excuses. Point to your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's no room for excuses. There's no room for a pity party. Then look down and say, you gotta push if you feel like you're all alone. Jesus, he was alone. Feel like they talking about you. Jesus, they talk about Jesus, but that didn't give him a reason to stop. But he kept hearing the cross. He kept hearing the cross. Because he knew that destiny was pushing him. And Jesus, he knew that lived. No stop from this nightmare situation that you were going to be sitting at the right hand of the Father. So I come to tell you that you keep on pushing. You better push through the valley of the shadow of death, because God is still with you. And I come to decree and I declare that every God-given assignment for your life will push you this year. Every God-given assignment will push you. Throw your hands up and say, I decree and I declare that every God-given assignment will push me this year and not make me give up.
an option. Failure is not an option. But the push will keep you motivated. The push will keep you motivated. Talk out your neighbor and say, neighbor, we gotta push. We gotta push. Don't give up and don't give in. I know that God is gonna meet your need. Hallelujah. Come on and preach to your neighbor. Say, neighbor. Say, neighbor. Oh, neighbor. I don't know what you're going through. I will look at you now. God is pushing you in a new direction. God is pushing you in a new situation. And guess what, neighbor? The situation, it looks mighty good. If you stay with him and allow him to push you, everything that comes your way will keep pushing you. And you'll find yourself forever in the mess. Say, neighbor, don't give up and don't give in. Now is not the time to quit, but now is the time to be pushed in the rope. Push your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm not trying to hurt you, but I'm trying to help you. Come on, push them one time and say, neighbor, that's what the Spirit wants to do for you. If you've never been filled with the Holy Ghost, the Spirit wants to push you into that rank. If you never shouted in your life, if you go with God, the Spirit will push you, and you'll find your feet moving, and you'll find your head bothered, and you'll find yourself doing the funky chicken. And look at your neighbor and say, stay with the push. Stay with the push. I believe that the push inside of me fills you in. That the push inside of you fills you in. You gotta stay with God, because God wants to push you to your fullest potential. You're making bad days now, but if you trust God and pray to God, they'll push you so you can shut it more. They'll push you so you can focus more. Hallelujah. Somebody shout. Somebody shout with praise. I've got a push. They're pushing me. Hallelujah! 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 Put your hands up and say, I'll push! Push me, Lord! Push me, Lord! And one thing about it is that when God pushes you, you won't get hurt. You won't regret, because he's pushing you in the way, in the path that he has planned for you. So one more time, throw your hands up and say, Lord, push me! Push me. I don't want to stop here. I don't want to die here. But push me until I become somebody great. Until I become somebody great. Until success is all over me. Push me into that brand new job. Push me into that brand new house. Push me until I'm filled with the Spirit. Push me until I'm filled with the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah. And so the Bible says that when she pushed herself, hallelujah, we found the woman crawling on the ground. We found her crawling on the ground. Sometimes,
thank you, Jesus.
You got to do something different to get different results. There was a crowd, there was a multitude all around them, but they were standing.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the multitude was touching God, touching Jesus. But there was something different about the woman that she said, I'm going to do something a little different because I'm desperate. And I believe something pushed her to do something different.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because the Bible says she touched the hem, and the hem was at the bottom.
Yes.
And it's not a hem that we find in our pants and in our your dresses, but they're tassels and stuff that were hanging off of Jesus. And she touched the hem of it. You can't touch the hem standing up. So there was something that pushed her and drove her to do something different.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. And once she did that, Jesus said, "Who touched me?" You have to realize that everybody was around him touching him. But there was something about her touch. There was a need in her touch.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Everybody wanted to touch him. And they wanted to touch him just to say, "Oh, I touched Jesus. I touched him."
Yes.
Guess what? He was there like, "I touched him." She didn't want to brag about it. She needed to touch him. She had a need. And so I come to tell you today that we are to push ourselves this year. In 2012, I believe that God is looking for people that are going to push for whatever. He has stuff waiting for us.
Yes.
But he can't give it to us if we're not ready, if we're still doing the daily routine, and we're getting bored. Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
But I pray that the Spirit of God will touch each and every one of us in this place. Hallelujah. Touch our hearts, touch our minds, God. Give us the drive again.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Give us that momentum, God. Build our faith back up. That it shall come to pass. The end of the story, he told the woman, "Go on and be healed." Your faith has made you healed. Let's all stand to our feet and give God praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a push in you. There's a push in you. Come in here and say, "We're going to be pushed this year."